So what does that turn out to be?
It turns out to be as follows. So it turns out V sub t is L naught of t. So L naught of t is t minus t sub 1 divided by t sub naught minus t sub 1. So I'm just repeating t minus t sub 2 divided by t sub naught minus t sub 2. T minus t sub 3 divided by t naught minus t sub 3 times the velocity at t sub naught. Then the second, those are four parts. So the second part is L sub 1t times the value of the velocity at t sub 1. So that will be t minus t sub naught divided by t1 minus t naught times t minus t sub 2 divided by t sub 1 minus t sub 2. So as you're seeing here that we are skipping t sub 1, whether it's here or here, because that's the j not equal to I part. And again, it will be t minus t sub 3 divided by t sub 1 minus t sub 3 times the velocity at t sub 1. Similarly, we have L sub 2t now. So it will be t minus t naught divided by t2 minus t naught here times t minus t1 divided by t sub 2 minus t sub 1. And then we're going to again skip the 2 because it will become 0 here otherwise. So that's the way the formula works. I'm not saying that's why we are doing that. But we're t minus t sub 3 now, skipping t sub 2 here, divided by t sub 2 minus t sub 3 times the value of the velocity at t sub 2. It might seem to be algebraically complicated, but again, if you follow the principles of what each of the L's are, then it is not. So again, if you look at L3 of t, it'll be t minus t naught divided by t sub 3 minus t sub naught. So t sub 3 will be in all the denominators. So it'll be t sub 3 minus t sub 1 here, and then t sub 3 minus t sub 2 here. So if you want to look at it that way. But t sub 3 minus t sub 3 will not be there because I is not equal to j. Then at the top, it'll be t sub t minus t naught, t minus t sub 1, t minus t sub 2. And t minus t sub 3 will not be there because it is L3. And so that's the way it flows. So all I have to do now is to substitute the values of t0, t1, t2, t3, and so on and so forth. And I'm not going to show you those because it's simply just substituting those values. So I'll just write down what values you have to substitute in here. So going back to what we had said, t sub naught is 10. The value of the velocity of t sub naught is equal to 227.04. So wherever there's t sub naught, you're going to substitute 10. Wherever the velocity of t sub naught is 227.04. And then wherever there's t sub 1, which is 15, you're going to substitute the velocity of t sub 1, which is 362.78. Wherever there is t sub 2, you're going to substitute 20. And your velocity at t sub 2 to be 517.35. And wherever there is 22.5, you're going to substitute the velocity of t sub 3 to be 602.97. So that's what you're going to do. And you can see that everything is here. Everything is in this formula here. Let me go and look back at the top of the formula here. So if you look at this particular formula, everything which we have written down here, t sub naught, t sub 1, t sub 2, t sub 3, the velocities at t sub naught, velocity at t sub 1, velocity at t sub 2, velocity at t sub 3, and just the t is not there because it is the Lagrangian polynomial which you're trying to find as a function of time. But since we are interested in finding the value of the velocity at 16, that's what we're going to substitute for time t equal to 16. Since we are finding the velocity at 16, we're going to substitute t equal to 16 in there. So if you go ahead and do those substitutions, what's going to happen is the velocity at 16 will turn out to be as follows. You get minus 0.0416. This will be L naught of t times 227.04. So if you look at this quantity here, is not nothing but L naught at 16. And then plus, you'll have 0.832 times the value of the velocity at T sub 1, which is 362.78. And this is nothing but the L naught at, this is nothing but L1 at 16. Then plus 0.312 times the value of the velocity at T sub 2, which is 517.35. And again, this is L2 at 16. Then plus minus 0.1024 times the value of the velocity at 602.97, which is the velocity T sub 3. And this is nothing but L3 at 16. So these are the weights which you are calculating for the time t equal to 16. If you add all the weights, you are going to get 1. And these are the weights which are given to each individual velocities which are given to you. And this turns out to be 392.06 meters per second. So that's how the Lagrangian interpolation works for this example for the cubic interpolation part. And that is the end of this segment.